Good Sunday morning, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. So yes, it's a Sunday, and Sunday is when we do our reviews. So we have got a review to do today. Something that actually we don't really need anymore. Now and again, we will carry one, but you know, for 90% of the people out there, they haven't got an inverter in the van. So they look for other ways and other means to actually get a 240 power source while they're off grid. AllPowers is a company we've worked with in the past and we rate them highly. Now, when they reached out to us and asked us to review their R1500 Lite, we said yes, because we know 90% of people out there still rely on a different power source to get 240 within the van while off grid. Along with that, we have been sent the SP033 solar panel. It's a foldable solar panel and gives you 200 watts to keep that charged while out and about on the road. So we're going to get in the box and see what the differences are between the R1500 and their new version, the R1500 Lite. Right, so straight out of the box, you do get the instruction manual, different languages and stuff in there that will explain everything to you. Also with the 240 power cable to charge the device up if you're not charging it or via solar. And with the charge on AC, it is a quick recharge. It can be fully recharged from flat in 90 minutes. It's got 1600 watts, which is the slight difference between their R1500 and the Lite version, 1600 watts of AC power. So it pretty much could charge most items. Now it does look like their older version. Most things here look the same. So you have got nice big covers. Oh, they're quite tight actually. Nice big covers on the 3-pin plug sockets, 4 along the bottom there. So that'll give you 240 power right there. Up at the top there, you've got your USB-A's. They're only 18 watt charge and you've got USB-C's at 100 watts charge there. So that's a good fast charge on the unit. Also, you have your 12 volt DC cigarette lighter type socket, comes standard on these. Now, there's the AC running up. Sometimes you can hear the fan kick in. I've heard it click over. And until we really start running items, then the fan will stay off. But that is pretty much ready to go. We'll go through the solar. Like we say, we're going to put in the 200 watts. There's not much sun out today. And just to see what happens there, and I will show you the solar panel at that time. Just point to note on this, you can have up to 650 watts of solar charging this up. So you can, if you had the solar panels to do so, it would charge in about 2 to 2.5 hours on solar on a good day, which is great, really, because you can keep this charged up when you're out at a festival or, you know, doing a few days off grid. Via the sun for free. It's ideal really for caravans, camper vans, motorhomes, tents, or even as a backup in your own home. It has got the up system, so uninterrupted power supply 24/7. So you can have this plugged into the wall, keep this charged as your AC, and then plugged into important work you're doing on a computer. Say if you were to have a power shortage in your house, anything like that, it will take milliseconds to kick this in and keep that your items running. It could be your fridge or anything like that, so you could have it as a backup power source at home, and that's another ideal thing. So I keep one in my storage unit and it runs power tools and everything like that. The battery that's inside this system is a LiFePO₄ battery, and pretty standard out there now and quite user-friendly, I suppose. I never had any issues with the LiFePO₄, but we're going to literally put it through a couple of tests just to see what the 1600 watts can do. Because it has got the surge on it, it should handle things like your microwave, your air fryer. Not at the same time, I wouldn't have thought, just because it hasn't got the watts to do so. But a microwave will always state certain wattage, but I can guarantee it will surge past that. Can this handle that? Now, the microwave we have got in the motorhome is only an 800 watt. Now, it will surge higher than that. And the air fryer, we've only got an 800 watt as well. This should handle it no problem at all. I do wonder if it can handle it both. Now, the surge might stop that from happening, because, well, 2 800 watts is 1600 watts, isn't it? And that's what it states it can do. So who knows? Let's have a look and see if we can do that. I'm not going to plug it into the van, so everything's live. I'm literally going to go straight off the power station. As you can see behind me, it's all set up. I've got an extension lead going into the microwave. The weight of this is 15 kilos. It's pretty much the same size as there are 1,500 looking at it. No difference there. It might be that little bit lighter. And the surge on this, before we get going, so the actual surge is 3,200 watts. Microwave's flashing, so let's get the an instant start going on the microwave. So the microwave is working. And if we look down here, it's already surged up to 1,137 watts, 39. For an 800 watt microwave, it's producing more power on startup. Let's get the air fryer going then. We'll bring it down to 180, which is quite standard for most items. And we'll get that going. So that has just started up. Oh, that's a little baby. That's only surging up to 911. Over the 800 watts, so that ain't too bad really. So this can handle that air fryer, it can handle the microwave we've got, but let's see if it can handle both without tripping it out. So, instant start. No, so the surge on that would have literally been too much, and it cuts it out. So that's fine. So with the microwave and air fryer together, it's a no-go, but separately, you can run them. If you do get the issue where you have to reset the device, it is literally just a case of turning it off, turn it on again, and then press the AC, and then everything will be up and running as normal. So we know now it can run the microwave, we know it can run the air fryer on a separate basis, but can it run the microwave and charge up a device as well? So I got my phone charging, and we'll see if the microwave will carry on. Now, I'm expecting it will because it has got the wattage there. Like I say, it's 1,600 watts with a 3,200 watt surge. So in theory, that'd be no problem for it. I mean, we're now on, you know, 1,100 fluctuating around that area. So we can have a few phones in this, no problem, and be charging up while we're using the microwave and stuff like that. It's another great item from AllPowers. If you haven't got an inverter in your van and you're looking for 240, this will handle, you know, a decent size hairdryer. This will handle hair straighteners. It's a nightmare when you're not on power and you need your 240. So for me, power stations are always a great idea. And we used them time and time again when we didn't have the inverter in the van. And now and again, we still take one with us to stick in the awning because it's portable. And that's the joy with it. Everything's within the unit and it's portable and you can take it wherever you want. So I'm going to show you the solar panel now. I'm going to set that up outside, see if you actually get any sun. But this is the SP033 200 watt solar panel. It looks nice and light. I'll quickly show you before it's unfolded. Literally comes in a nice packet like that. And as you can see there, it's not that heavy at all. And all your wires and stuff are in here. So if we open this up, that's what you're connecting to these wires that will connect into the power station. All comes with it. You even get a packet here of little adapters. So if you have got other power units that you want to charge and their adapters are slightly different from these ones, then you can fix these onto the end of this and use this solar panel for that. I've got the lead here. Now these are the two adapters that basically fit. Now they literally just clip. You can't get it wrong. There is a male and female, as you can see there. They're both clipped in. Now that's for your adapters, but this is the one we're going to plug into the unit. Now on the side here, because there is four ways to charge this, and you can charge it solar and AC at the same time. There we go. Right, that's plugged in. In theory, if there's any sun at all, it should start giving us some charge. And it is. And you should be able to see there that that's 28 watts, 29 watts coming in. 30, 31, 36. Oh, the sun's coming out a little bit more. 76, 102, 148, 166, 173. Okay,
That's probably about right.
So as you see there, that was a 200 watt solar and we got it up to about 176 watts coming in. The sun behind me is just breaking through the clouds, but it is a bit cloudy today. The solar panel itself, as you can see there, it comes in four square sections, but it does fold up nice and light, nice and small, but it gives you a nice bit of coverage. You know, if you have this charged or charging at the same time you're using the power station, then obviously you're prolong the life of that battery usage. So ideal system really. What do we think of AllPowers then? Well, we love AllPowers and it's a solid build. This product here is made to last. Around about 3,500 cycles in this, so it's gonna last you a long, long time. It's quiet in operation. It's got plenty of ports. Now they have got plenty of other power stations if you need to go bigger, but bigger obviously comes in bigger sizes. So, you know, you've got to bear in mind your space of when you're traveling and what you actually need it for. I'll be quite happy to use this and on the road. And like I say, it will easily do our low watt kettle, which is a 900 watt kettle. It'll easily do the microwave, easily do the air fryer. So it's covered our most of our items there. And of course it's gonna charge laptops, phones, and all that, etc., quite easily. Now it's 1,056 watt hours is the battery capacity. Just bear that in mind when you are using high powered items, it will drain down that little bit quicker. But overall, what a great product. Now, if you are looking for any AllPowers or power stations, there will be a link in the description for this item, for the solar panel, and to their website where you can find plenty of other power solutions for when you're on the road and off grid and need that power supply. We will see you on Sundays for reviews. However, we will see you for our normal vlog days on a Thursday at 5:30 in the evening, where we will be carrying on with our normal vlogging. So hope for this has been help to you. And if you are looking for a power source for your motorhome, camper van, caravan, or whatever, or even a backup at home, and you've got any comments, please comment below. I will do my best to answer and help you, get powered up. So until the next one, see you later.